I've been lucky enough to be cast as Jack Crawford, who's the head of behavioral sciences at the FBI, who in Silence of the Lambs was played by Scott Glenn and who was played by Dennis Farina in Manhunter. So I'm really kind of excited and lucky. I get to puppeteer in a strange way at the beginning of this thing. I recruit Will Graham to start profiling a serial killer whose identity is unknown to us. And then I recruit Dr. Lecter to assist me with Will Graham, because Will Graham is such a savant, if you will. He's a highly sensitive, intuitive guy who profiles serial killers, if you will. And he runs the risk of losing himself in his work. So I recruit Dr. Lecter to sort of help me handle him, I suppose, is the best way of putting it. Maz is really, really a terrific actor. I'm a fan of his work. Again, he has that kind of sophistication and elegance and supreme intelligence that I think is going to really shine and come through and make his Hannibal Lecter quite irresistible. There's a murder that takes place that's quite gruesome, we discover Will Graham is lecturing at the FBI. My character Jack goes to him and tries to recruit him to help him find this killer that's out there. And then at the same time, I go to Lecter and say, listen, I'm working with somebody who I think is in danger of becoming unstable if he gets too close to some of the subjects that he's dealing with. So I'd like you to work with him and help him stay within the lines, if you will. The wonderful thing about the show is that over the course of the season, you will see Jack Crawford, Will Graham, and Hannibal Lecter interacting quite often. And more often than not, they'll all be in pursuit of the same killer, which is an interesting idea based on what we know about these characters and where they eventually wind up. This show presents them as allies at the very beginning. And so there's all kinds of room for a very interesting kind of dynamic to develop. So I think there's always an appetite in the general public for the bizarre, the strange, the macabre. I think it's part of human nature, that dark side of us. But the other thing is, you know, as with all, I think, sort of crime-based shows, there's also the need to know that there are people that are out there who are going to solve these crimes, who are going to bring these killers to justice, who are going to try and make it right. There have been other versions of this that were very successful. And so to revisit those might not instill one with the kind of confidence one wants to have when approaching something like this. So I was very, very comfortable just knowing that I was going to work with Hugh Dancy, who's a wonderful actor, Mads Mikkelsen, who's a wonderful actor, Brian Fuller, who's a terrific writer, and just trust that we would, you know, be able to take these characters and, you know, make something interesting. I think we would all like to eat the rude. I think that's why it's kind of catchy. You know, we've all had those encounters with people who we thought were being rude. They didn't necessarily think they were being rude, but we thought they were. And so, wouldn't it be nice if you could just correct them by slaying them and eating them?